Hi, it's Susanna Troy. In today's New York Daily News, we have an article in Gatecrasher by Frank about Rudy Giuliani possibly running for president. And if he does, he's going to have to explain about SAIC and CityTime. It says, Rudy may have to run on CityTime. What's the connection between Rudy Time and CityTime? As Rudy Giuliani considers a 2012 bid for president, political pundits are predicting that Science Application International Corp's business ties to members of his mayoral administration will bring unwanted scrutiny should he throw his hat in the ring. First of all, rewind. Rudy brought in SAIC. Rudy brought in CityTime. New York City Gov had a payroll system, and it worked. Rudy was the man that started this idea of cutting New York City Gov out of handling its own payroll system and going outside. At one point, it was Maximus, and I believe Rudy wasted about $500 million, and the man he brought in to handle Maximus went from NYC Gov in a failed system to a job at the White House. So he ended up bringing CityTime and SAIC. When he did that, he had a deputy mayor, Peter Powers, okay? So there you already have a relationship with Rudy, SAIC, and Peter Powers. Peter Powers now is the lobbyist for this MTA deal. Peter Powers represents SAIC in the MTA deal that we all said, no, this cannot happen. And Dinopoli killed the deal. They're saying, you could kill this deal, it's still going through. I don't know, that's why the MTA is in such bad shape, and it just has a history of corruption. This deal is corrupt. There's no doubt in my mind that the SAIC MTA deal is corrupt. But let's get back to Rudy Time and CityTime. When people like Rudy and Mike talk White House, their number one goal is to be president. But even if they don't become president, they still want to be a player in terms of White House politics and in terms of the global playing field. Hence SAIC and wanting a relationship with them. But when it costs the taxpayers a fortune, and SAIC has proven to be the taxpayers' Titanic with CityTime, we don't want to enter into an MTA deal with them. Now think about SAIC. They hold all the power. They understand and have the codes and how the system works for CityTime, and they don't want to share it with New York City Gov. They haven't yet shared that, which puts us in a very vulnerable situation, even deeper financial hole. But think about it. SAIC runs our payroll, right? And now they want to be underground with our MTA. Those are pretty strategic places to be for New York City. It's very interesting. And if this deal goes through and SAIC goes over their budget, Greg Mocker from WPIX exposed that New York City taxpayers are going to have to pay SAIC if they go over budget. And they certainly did with CityTime. We were going to spend $68 million, and we spent, I think, about $760 million. And based on the fact we don't have codes and we don't have system, we're going to of how it operates, we're going to have to spend over $1 billion, if not more, to get this fully expanded and up and running. So with CityTime and SAIC, apparently there was a deal with New York City government, if and when we ever get it up running, that the city would go out and sell this to other government agencies. And so then the city would get a commission on any system they sold, anybody they could sell this idea of CityTime to, well, I guess along with SAIC, on behalf of SAIC. So I'm just wondering, is there a deal that we don't know about with the MTA and SAIC and NYC Gov? They're not forthcoming with information. Like, remember SAIC Sanitation Department? We didn't even know about that. And when Dinopoli killed the MTA SAIC deal, or we thought he killed it, also, what was killed was an SAIC MTA deal. So my concern is how much we, the public, do not know, considering it is our taxpayer money. And the MTA, one way or another, it's our taxpayer money, because when they override, the bill will come to us. This really sinks to high heaven. He also Frank talks about Sal Salomon, who was a hired consultant to SAIC for CityTime project. Sal worked for New York City Gov, and he's supposed to be a very smart guy and a great worker, so I can't help but wonder, why didn't he say anything? Why didn't he notice something was suspicious? And I had done an earlier YouTube about this woman, Gibbs, who's now Mike Bloomberg's deputy mayor, and she was Bondi's boss, and she had to know about Mazur. So again, I'm wondering, you're deputy mayor now. Why didn't you say, hey, Mike, hey, somebody? Why didn't somebody? I just am stunned at what's going on. And the last thing I would need to say is, I've heard rumors that there were SAIC employees that lied on their timesheets and were stealing money. Now, I don't know if that's true, but in the Village Voice article, they talk about two SAIC employees that went back to SAIC, and they complained and said something's wrong here, and they said something, and SAIC's response was, you're fired. The point is, why haven't we heard of any arrests for SAIC employees lying on their timesheets? We have the whistleblower, CNN iReport, who fingers a guy called Jelly Bean, a middle-aged guy who's he felt was stealing. Why no arrest of Jelly Bean? And I heard a rumor there may have been some people that rather than be arrested, they've chosen to give evidence. But if so, we haven't heard about it. We, the people of New York, and we... I'm just wondering if there is any cover-up for SAIC employees' improprieties or stealing or lying on their timesheets because they want this MTA deal to go through. You can't help but wonder about these questions. You just can't help but wonder.